everyone, this is Lisa from Canine Clips, and this is Remy. And Remy is a Shih Tzu cross, and he is coming today for a full groom. And we're going to get him all cleaned up. So I'm going to be giving him a number 7 cut blade, and with just a short scissor cut face. So we are going to get started. Here, so I'm trying to get you so you can see what I'm doing. And if you do like this video, I'd appreciate it if you could please subscribe to my channel. I'm always looking for more subscribers. I need those. That would be greatly appreciated. You can always check out my channel. I do have lots of videos. I do like to post every day a new video. I have lots of videos to choose from as well. I've already posted quite a few, so I do a few different types of videos, just if there's any health issues specifically, or also just if you're looking to focus on something specific on your dog in the grooming process. I do have a couple playlists compiled there, so you can just find those. And then, of course, I have lots of full videos of the full groom. I'm not going to worry too much in here because I'm going to be using a number 7. You can lay down. There you go. Remy's been coming to me for quite a few years, so he's quite relaxed, as you can tell. But of course, still doesn't want to be here. But he knows it has to get done. He's a much happier dog when we're all done and he's waiting for his owners. Just like any other dog, including my dog. I still have to hunt him down when it's time to get him grooming. It's like he can read my mind. Every other day he's good, but the day I want to groom him, he's hiding somewhere. He likes the attention afterwards and how he feels. So, okay. Remy has quite a bit of hair in his ears, but he's actually very healthy. Very healthy ears. Just switching out my scissors. Those other ones are getting pretty dull. Okay, so I'm going to turn him so maybe you can see a little bit of the hair in there. I know it's hard to see, but I'm going to get that all plucked out. Just got a little bit of pinkness started, but still really, really healthy. So once I get all this out, the color should return to normal. But he does have a lot in there. Here's our first little clump, and there's still just a little bit left, which we'll get out here, and then he'll be all good. And we'll get to that other ear. All right, perfect. So there is the rest of it. Land it on your head. All right, and I'm just gonna move up to the other side. We'll also do the other ear. About the same amount of hair on this side as well. We'll get that cleaned out for him. You can see it comes out quite easily in the ear. Just a little annoying, I'm assuming. Just irritating, but not painful, thankfully. Some dogs will wince and whine, but usually that's because there's a whole bunch of wax in there and then the ears are a little bit irritated and sore. So when you're plucking it out, it can be a little irritating for them, a little bit more. But it's good to get that hair out to keep those ear canals really clean. So when the wax gets too thick in there, it sticks to that hair, which is all this, and then it gets heavy. And then falls back into the ear canal, which makes it really irritated and red and can give it some swelling. So it's always good to keep that hair out. And then when the dog shakes or scratches his head, that wax has nothing to stick to and will actually come out. All right, there we go. So not too much, as it came out nice and easy. Quite the little hair there. Just take a little bit off the top. Okay, and since he likes laying down, I'm going to raise the table up to start on his feet. Just because he looks so comfy. Hey, buddy. I know. He looks so sad. Take me home. You're such a good boy. Okay. So, come here, buddy. We'll start with this paw. Yeah, up, good boy. And they do have lots of hair in them, as you can see. So I'll get that all cleared out. And he's got nice, thick nails too. Helps to have nice sharp scissors for this process, because his feet are a little bit matted in between the pads, so that I'm able to get in between them to get these mats out. And you want to make sure you get underneath them and go slow. Okay. He's starting to snore a little bit. You really get comfortable, don't you, there, buddy? Okay, no dew claws. Yeah, no dew claws. Okay, so we'll start on the back foot here. Here, I'm just going to twist you a little bit, buddy. There you go. That's why I like a table that has no grip, because I can just maneuver them as well. I have an older senior dog that has trouble standing. I usually put a towel down if they need a little bit of grip, but that's very rare. A lot of them do like to lay down, but if there are ones that are keep trying to get up and trying to get up, then I'll kind of work with them as well. But most of them are content with just laying down. A little bit sensitive. Okay. Somebody has ticklish feet. Okay, so now we're going to work on the other side. Yes, I know. Okay, come on up. There you go, good boy. Get that out of your way. Okay. See the mat in that one there? Just make sure I get under it. There we go. So there's a fair good mat. So that makes their feet, can make their feet a little bit sore when it starts spreading those pads out. You could see maybe your dog chewing on his feet possibly. Especially when that snow comes, that gives the snow lots to stick to as well. So then their feet get a little bit irritated because the snow is clumped on in there and kind of freezes in there. Okay, one more down, and just one left to go. And he does have a dock tail, so I won't need to comb that out before we take him to the bath. Good boy. Last one. Okay, just about done, buddy. Probably dreaming on his couch, laying in his doggy bed. Okay. Soon, buddy. Soon. Just about done. Luckily, they're not here all day with me. They're just here for their hour appointment. So the dogs come and get groomed and they get picked up in an hour. So they're not here all day. Just like to book one dog at a time. Then that way they're not here all day and that creates less stress for them and they're not running randomly in here. They're just, I have a little baby gated area that they get to hang out while they wait for their owner. Dogs that have been here a few times understand what's going on, so they look forward to getting into that baby cage because they know that's the last stage before they get picked up. All right, so now it's bath time. So I'm just going to move him to the tub. Hey, you ready? Okay, come on up. There you go. Okay. He's so relaxed. Okay, well, let's see how you do for your bath, okay? Head on the you're such a silly boy. There you go. Are you resting? It's hard to stand, eh? everything nice and clean. Okay. Extra water. Okay. Oh my God. Table. Okay, back to the table. Come on, baby. Go stand up. There you go. That's a good boy. Okay, now time for the blow dry. I think we're going to put this one on you. It's going to fit. Ready? Takes off the bulk of the moisture, but of course his fur is still going to be a little bit moist, so I am just going to cut with that. It helps to keep the clippers a little bit cooler, and then I will, as you will see, after I'm done this clip, I'll go back and blow dry once again And then come back with the clippers again. And it'll really give a nice clean finished look. So as I said before, I'm going to use a number 7 blade. Get under all this fur. And of course, you still want to always check the temperature of the blades. He likes to lay down. I'll work with him best I can with him laying down, but I'll try to get him to stand when I do the leg areas. It just gives a cleaner cut. But if he, you know, needs to lay down, then I just work around him too. So, and I just get the best cut I can working with them. Okay, you ready? Okay, up, up, up. I know. He gave me a groan. He's like, oh man, I don't want to stand. There you go, good boy. See, there's a little bit of matting inside the leg here. Okay. Okay. I'll just go a little bit up, but I'll actually finish that area with the number 10. Then I'll be able to get under that a little bit better. Okay, so we got that half done. Okay, I'm going to do it on your neck. Gives me a groan when I move him. I know, that's a rough life. come on up. Up, 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 buddy. Come on, up, up, up. Up, up, up. Good boy. I know. Stay up, bud. Okay. My boy likes to lay down. So again, I'm going to come back with the number 10 in that area. Good boy, we got it. Okay, so let's see if I can get him to stand again. I'm gonna do under this chest area. See that a lot, so we'll just kind of want to hold them up from underneath. And I'm going to use a number 10 in that area. And a lot more stuff likes to stick there. And it's also more apt to be prone to get matted as well, so. Have some stuff stuck in there. Okay. So since he does have some stuff stuck in there, when I'm done grooming, I usually go back with a paper towel and some shampoo and clean up that area. Just to freshen that up as well. Come on. Alright, okay. Okay, so now that I got the majority of it all done, I'm going to give him another blow dry. Hey, I know. There you go. Okay. All right, so we'll give another quick blow dry here. So now we're just going to do the final cleanup. And get this boy ready to go home. All right, so we're gonna get the number 7 blade again. And we'll go over the body again. And just catch anything that may have gotten missed the first time. So this is just more to clean up the whole body. And give it a nice, clean, finished look. Okay, come on. See, he's not a big fan of standing, so I'm going to just work with him laying down. Alright, so just finishing up here. So I hope you enjoyed the video. And like I said earlier, if you'd like to see more videos, please subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate that. That really helps me out when I get more subscribers. And you can let me know in the comments if you'd like to see something specific as well. And I'll try to post that when I can, just through my regular grooming every day. And I can try to put it on when it comes available, because I don't know when something's going to be available until they're here being groomed. So thanks for taking the time to watch. Hope you keep watching. There we go, buddy. So I usually just finish with some ear solution. And I'll be wiping up his bum as well. And then that's all for Remy for today. Yeah, you're all done, buddy. Well, there is Remy all done. He's just going to lay down on the drop. But thanks for taking the time to watch. And take care and have a great day. We'll see you again.